we are with us. We have artists, Mbongeni Buthelezi and Giuliano Giacovazzi. And now you are a man who builds villages around the world for big events. And Mbongeni, you're an artist. We've got a piece of your work here. Just tell us exactly how you create this to start off with.
Okay, my work is predominantly plastics, and what I do, I use plastic as a canvas, and also all the colors that you see there are predominantly from plastics. I don't use any form of paint in my work.
So you it's all picked up from the street and you sort of burn it on?
Yeah, what I do, I've reached a point where I'm not picking up anymore. I'm working with people who allow me to mix the colors that I want and hit them with a heat gun onto the surface and get all the layers that you see there.
Now, Giuliano, just give us an outline exactly what you do. I mean, what your idea was.
Well, I'm the founder of Hostival, which is the world's only completely nomadic festival hostel, where we would set up accommodation entertainment villages at the world's biggest events. So it'd be the big festivals like the Running of the Bulls in Pamplona, the Oktoberfest in Munich, the St. Patrick's, the Rio Carnival, and then also big events, sporting events like the World Cup, the Euros, the Olympics. I'll keep on going.
Now, both of you have taken up what many people would consider slightly strange, off-the-track ways of becoming entrepreneurs. How did you get onto it, Mbongeni?
To be honest, it wasn't easy. It started when I was still a student, also trying to experiment and making sure that, you know, I achieve my dreams, you know, because art is so expensive. I mean, materials there are so expensive. So I wanted to be different, I wanted to be unique, and I wanted to come up with something that is uniquely South African.
And yourself, Giuliano, I mean, what sort of led you to do what you do? Because it is rather unusual. You're South African, and yet you spend all your time all over the world building hostels for people to live in when they go to these big events.
Well, Chris, I'm passionate about traveling, and you know, I didn't want to be constrained to having to live in a city where I'd be able to get a regular job and, you know, be a professional. So I pretty much invented this business so that I would be able to live the way that I'd want to live. And it started off in a little town in Spain where I was able to support myself off accommodating holidaymakers. And it just became so much fun that I kept on doing it on a bigger scale.
And yourself, Mbongeni, I mean, what were your humble beginnings as an entrepreneur in this?
Oh my goodness, it was very difficult. Very, very difficult. You know, I always knew that I wanted to be an artist, but I wasn't really too sure, you know, how to go about it, you know, even though I studied art, you know, it wasn't really easy, you know, at all, because I had very few people, you know, to look up to, you know, at the time when I started. But I had this passion, you know, for me to just keep going, you know, and eventually I realized that, oh, you know, if one, you know, really pushes as hard as he can, then eventually you achieve what you want to achieve.
And what did your parents say when you went to them and said, look, I want to be making my living as an artist?
Oh my goodness. At first they said, look, you are so lazy, you know, what kind of a man are you planning to be, you know, because every man wakes up in the morning, go to work, you know, gets paid at the end of the month. You know, you just want to wake up and draw the whole day. I mean, it doesn't really make sense. But I mean, I tried to convince them, and I really made it a point that, you know, each time I come back from school, I share, you know, my experiences for the day, you know, and eventually they got into it and they started, you know, supporting me.
And Giuliano, I mean, how shocked were your parents when you said you wanted to travel the world setting up villages for people?
Well, I thought they thought it was a phase I was going to get over, just get through it and then move on to something more professional. But I just ended up becoming a very lucrative business and still going strong.
Are they hoping one day that you'll get a proper job or what?
I think they've given up on that. They're not beating that drum anymore.
Now, Mbongeni, you're obviously trained as an artist.
Yes.
I mean, the quality of your work stands for that. But what about being trained as an entrepreneur? I mean, how difficult was it to make money out of something that's your passion?
Look, I mean, this is something that eventually it got into my head, you know, because at first I never looked at myself as a business person, you know. I thought that, look, to be an artist, you just make art and you give it away, you know. This is what I did at the beginning, you know, just to keep handing it out to people. But eventually I realized that, you know, I needed to make a living out of this, you know. It was very hard also, you know, to come up with ideas that will really put me at the level where I'll look at myself as an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
You know. So yeah, I mean, when I first started working with ArtSource, that was way back in 1993. At the time, I was still a student. You know, I hooked up with a lady by the name of Les Kohn, who is the founder, you know, of the ArtSource South Africa. You know, she introduced me to the idea of looking at yourself as a professional. You know, you sell your work, you make a living out of it. And later, I hooked up with the Disciple Gallery, you know, in Cologne. And, you know, then it just took off from there.
And Giuliano, in some ways, you had an advantage on most entrepreneurs because you actually studied it at university here in South Africa. What use was it to you?
University to me was fun. I didn't really, you know, take in much from the actual studies apart from socializing. So I don't think I've used anything from what I studied. I think, you know, if you have a passion for something, you want to achieve something, you just got to keep going at it until you achieve it and just make that achievement a reality.
Mbongeni, you've been going nearly 20 years.
Yes.
In hindsight, would you have preferred someone to train you in the business of making money, or did it just come to you?
To be honest, it just came to me. You know, I wasn't really trained as a business person, but you know, it just with time, you know, I gradually, you know, got into that level, because like I said before, that working with people who are in this business already, you know, it really prepared me, you know, somehow to realize that, look, you can't just keep making art and just giving it away. And also, you know, I knew very well that there is something that this is something that I can actually make a living out of it. And I knew also that there is nothing that I knew beyond art, you know? So I didn't really see myself as an IT specialist or as a doctor or something, you know? I wanted to be in this business.
Let's talk a little bit more about the nuts and bolts of your businesses now. How difficult was it, Giuliano, for you to make it in your type of business?
Oh, it is extremely difficult, and it still is difficult because, you know, I'm pioneering in a field that there's nobody to refer to. So when I approached city councils telling them that I'm going to temporarily set up a place for people to stay, you know, they can't believe that I'm actually approaching them with that. So it's a lot of, you know, it's battling through a lot of people's understanding of what is possible. So yeah, I think a lot of the main struggles for me has been to actually, you know, make people understand that this is something that can be done, that will be done, and making it work.
Mbongeni, what difficulties do you have in being an artist and an entrepreneur?
You see, I think the difficulty is obvious. I mean, I'm working with plastics. I mean, every time when I approach people or potential buyers, you know, they say, what is this? I mean, it's made out of plastics. I mean, it really... people are so scared into jumping into new things, you know? And this is the difficulty, because I'm doing something that has never been done before. You know, it's actually very hard to convince someone to purchase one of my artworks, you know, because of the same reason. As you might be aware, Chris, that, you know, if you say you're an artist, it's either you're a painter, you're a sculptor, or you draw, you know? So with plastics, really, it is something that you really need to be convinced, you know, for you to be able to invest into it. So for me, that is very, very challenging. And I'm hoping that, you know, in the near future, you know, people will realize that art is not always about, you know, purchasing expensive art materials.
And Giuliano, I mean, how difficult is it for you? I mean, bearing in mind your nomadic existence as an entrepreneur, you're always moving around. What are the problems like with cash flow and that sort of thing do you have?
Yeah, well, cash... fortunately, you know, I'm mainly operating out of Europe, so the Eurozone with the Euro makes it a lot easier. Though every city that I move to, prices are completely different, even within the same countries. So where I would be working at with a certain understanding of rental in one country would be completely different than the next. And my guests are all very international, so that they, you know, for them, they'd always be paying the standard Euro.
I mean, one of the big stories over the last couple of years, and I know that your work here appears in a lot of hotels and corporate places. Yes. Has the recession affected you as an entrepreneur?
Look, I mean, I to be honest with you, it never affected me that much, because I've been very fortunate, you know, to be able to working with people who helped me, you know, to go through this, you know, without even realizing that, you know, there is recession out there. You know, as an artist, yes, people are not buying as much as they would like to, you know. They try to save as much as they possibly can. But, you know, during that period, you know, I managed to get really big commissions, you know, like the one that I did for the Da Vinci Hotel. So for me, you know, it actually took me through, you know, that whole period, you know, without really focusing too much, you know, into what was happening in the world.
Now, Giuliano, you've done some of the big ones around the world. You've done the Beer Fest in Munich. You've done the Running of the Bulls in Pamplona. You've done the Carnival in Rio.
Yeah.
I mean, does the recession affect your kind of business?
Well, my answer is quite a surprising one. It's actually good for my business because I provide budget accommodation. So the people that would normally be staying in more expensive hotels would then be on a more of a budget, and they'd be booking with me. As well as surprising a lot of people when they'd be losing their jobs or they'd be out of work, that have this time on their hands, and it's not too expensive for them to pop over from a neighboring European country to these festivals. So if anything, recession's actually been surprisingly positive for Hostival.
So your sort of guys, you know, they're backpackers, they're ready to rough it, they just want somewhere to put their head for the night.
Yeah. Young travelers. It's also the backpacking industry. Backpacking is a massive trend amongst young travelers. So it's business is booming at the moment. It's the best time to be in the industry at the moment.